Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be teaching you how to make windows in SketchUp. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do here is actually make a wall so that we can make a hole. So we're going to make this wall here. I'm just going to make it a group so that I don't mess anything up. So you could assume that you have a whole building around this, but this is just one of your walls. And then I'm going to draw a rectangle for my window. Now I'm going to copy this. I'm going to hit Control C to copy this. Make this a group and then go into this group, edit, paste in place, and then just extrude that through. So hopefully there's a hole. So in this group, there is a hole, and then there's this other thing that I made, which will be my window. Make that a component, call this window. So now if I move this to the side, you can see there's a hole there. but as I start to make the window itself, it will make it super easy. So you can see there, I snap to the midpoint of that line. And I'm just going to offset this. So I'm just going to take that and move this. We'll say each is 2. So I'm going to move this back. I'm going to hide the rest of this so it makes it a little simpler for us to see. Move this back 2 inches. And then hit E and erase these guys. Now push pull this 2 inches. And this 2 inches. So now you can see there's a little offset. So when you raise the window, there's a place for it to go. Now what I want to do here is use the offset tool when I can find it. Here it is. We're going to do this 2 as well. So we have this guy. And then you can just double click here. You can also, when I push pull, you can also double click to push pull. We're going to push this in. There. Okay, so now we have these guys. Now these should be identical, so you could technically, let's actually just do that because it'll make our lives easier. Let's delete all this and make it a little bit easier. I'm just using the eraser tool here. Make group, make component, sash. Okay, take this, and I just want to double check and make sure it's right. It is. Now what I want to do in the middle is make a separate plane. This is going to serve as the glass. I'm just going to do a single pane of glass here that is one. Make sure that I'm in this group when I do this. Paste in place. Now in my default tray, if you don't have this open, you just want to go to window default tray, and instead of hide tray, it will say show tray, and make sure you have materials selected as well. In here under, there should be a thing called glass and mirrors. So these are set up for you already. You could always make your own custom material. We're just going to use, let's say, this translucent blue gray. The thing, if you're making your own, I'm just going to go to edit here, just make sure opacity is set to what you want. And if this is too dark, too opaque, or not opaque enough, you can always change this. So we got a little bit of blue here. So we have this window. Now let's put in some muttons, which is those little dividers that go inside. So I'll go back into this. Let's just eyeball it here. Looks good. So what I'm going to do is put this here. Make that a component. Mutton. Okay. Just going to look at this. Looks good. So what I need is there, and then I'm going to hide this for a second. I want to take this side and bring it all the way to here, to the end, and then use the forward slash. And divide. That looks a little too chunky. Let's go with 4. So that way these are equally spaced, and then you can delete these two guys at the start and the beginning. Go back to hidden geometry and unhide this. We got that guy. And then I'm going to take this, and I am pressing M here to move it, hitting control to make a copy. Rotate this 90 degrees. Find the midpoint. Going in the green direction, I'm going to hold shift here and then click this face. Because this is a uniform shape, it's pretty easy to get that. And then if I'm like too lazy to deal with this, what I might do is just bump it out. So we're going to choose, I have it come out, let's say 1/4 inch. So you could do something like that. That way you get rid of those little lines. Maybe that's too much. Maybe I'll try 1/8 inch. Just a little subtle bump out. You know, you can always bump it out on this side as well. And then you have this window that you can put anywhere. Just make sure your extra stuff is gone. And then within the window itself, something that helps your windows look more realistic is always, in architecture, it's nice to have the shadow lines of the window. So you might want to set this back a little bit. Maybe there's some trim like on the inside, or maybe there's some kind of surround on the outside. So if I come into here and I offset, just choose this guy. I'm going to close this and then I'm going to offset it just a little. There we go. So we have like a trim on the outside. And if you want it to be like a certain kind of profile, you can always do that as well. So what you might want to do, make this a separate group. But, you know, let's say I'm just going to make this up to use an arc. Maybe you want something that is like that. So you would select your shape that you're extruding around this rectangle. Select that guy. And then choose follow me. For some reason it didn't work, but you can always drag along this line. So I'm just holding left click here as I go through. You can see I have hidden geometry on, so I see those lines. But that's another way to do it as well. And you can get as fancy as you want with that. Selecting the lines works. You just might have to move that shape a little bit to get what you want. And then as an architect, one thing that I always do that's important to consider when you're doing this is that the front edge here should be, this whole thing should be sloped so that if any water comes down, it can go off. So it's pretty subtle, but could make a big difference. So I'm just going to move this down the slightest bit, but you can see there's a little slope there now. And my window is here. Turn this on. So I did move that, but I just want to bring this back up so that there's not such a huge gap. There you go. And then if you want to do the trim or whatever on the inside, you can do that as well. So hopefully this helped. If you liked this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.